We're going to unbox and review the Petron Tangent Evo Bluetooth wireless earphones in this video, bought during the festive sale period. The Petron Tangent Evo Bluetooth neckband earphones definitely falls in the ultra budget range segment for those who are looking to not spend a bomb of an amount for a Bluetooth wireless headphone. Why we decided to fuck up the Petron Tangent Evo with the force breaking tear down, we'll get to that later in the video. Even at this ultra budget pricing, the Tangent Evo has good stuff like IPX4 water resistance, voice assistance, Bluetooth 5.0, a built-in high definition mic, and claims to have deep bass, which indirectly suggests to the buyer that the sound quality is automatically of superior quality. Connecting or pairing it with a smartphone is not an issue, quite a smooth process in fact. You simply just need to long press the middle button till the LED light starts blinking to red, then pair it with your phone in Bluetooth settings. It takes about 6 seconds in total for the pairing and you're good to go. Everything seems great until now. Great color, seemingly good build quality, water resistance and premium looks at this budget price. But coming to the sound quality itself, that's why it starts to head towards huge disappointment and starts to show its true colors. The only thing we found the Petron Tangent Evo to be good at is during calls. The supposed HD mic works well for the other party and no issues in listening to the caller's voice through the Bluetooth earphones. But that's where the fun ends. The actual audio quality is one of the worst we have experienced compared to previous bad ones reviewed earlier. The audio quality sounds muffled, muddy, with absolutely no high frequency range, no clarity, and definitely no deep bass as falsely advertised. So we decided to break it out of spite due to its pathetic audio quality with a forced tear down and break test. Completely turning it 360 degrees in the opposite direction does not seem to compromise the structure or damage the thin portion of the plastic construction, so that can never be an issue during regular use. You can have some fun getting a lovely heart shape if you forcibly press it down the middle. This is not going to make any difference to the functions though. Getting to the opposite side where there are no physical buttons, it becomes clear that the plastic here can easily break with not much force. It also tells us that this part contains a small battery, which has gotten a bit warm from all the force on the plastic enclosing. The device itself is still functional. The bit of bend pressure on the button side exposes the tiny internal circuitry and at last kills the Petron Tangent for good, putting it to sleep forever. Thin plastic cable is in fact not that weak as unexpected, but what about when the pressure is applied near the plastic casing? It is able to survive a few beatings until it gets stretched out and thin, ultimately snapping out of the poor casing.